Hi folks, this is Pitch Mario with the 14th video of the Script Manager how-to. And instead of the ToggleMe macro, this is a short discussion about lists and list variables. Because I had a closer look at the last video and is the name current tiddler, which is always coming up. But current tiddler can have different values. So that's why I want to discuss a little bit about the list widget and the current tiddler variable. So first let's have a look at the current tiddler variable here, which is set by the TiddlyWiki core by convention. So in this case it is draft of new tiddler 4. So this is the current tiddler. So this is the real tiddler name which all the contents is placed in. Okay, if I create a list widget with a filter, with a tag to do, and I call current tiddler here, I get all the elements. Oh, it's not very nice, so say comma space. Okay, so now I get the different tiddlers or the titles of the tiddlers which are tagged to do. Yeah? So everything which is inside the body of the list element, so from the starting list here until the end of the list here, now has current tiddler. And that's the behavior of the list widget. Yeah? So it iterates over every tiddler and checks if the tiddler is tagged to do and gives us the result in the current tiddler variable. Yeah? So if I copy this variable over here, I can see outside of the list element, yeah, the current tiddler variable is again draft of new tiddler 4. And this is very, very important. So with TiddlyWiki, those variable names have a scope, and the scope of current tiddler, if it is created with the list widget, is inside the body. Yeah? So only here current tiddler has this value. If I say variable, I can modify the variable name. Now you can see it changed it. Yeah? So now I change it back to XX. So now the variable which the list widget is modifying is named XX. Yeah? And with my last example, I did call it list item. List item. And now this gives us a very interesting behavior. Yeah? So if we want to create a dynamic name, for example, I want to create AAA.list, yeah, I can define a macro and new name. And now I can say I want to use the variable of the current tiddler dot list. And then instead, and here I can say new name. Ah, sorry, not current tiddler, it's list item. Yeah, so there you can see, yeah, so we have the current tiddler, the list item is AA, and the new name is AA.list, dot list here, yeah. And this is important. So then you have the possibility to use, say, different or to create temporary titlers. Yeah. So that's exactly what I did. First, if I say new here, it creates batch processing dot link. So it uses the current titler name. Yeah. And then again here, yeah. It's used with current titler, where current titler, sorry, batch processing, where current titler is set to batch processing dot links, yeah, and then this is the index, yeah, so then the index is created very very similar to this one, yeah. Yeah, so I could say, for example, say current titler dot dot list item. Yeah. And then you can see now if current titler, or if this titler would be a JSON titler, I can access the different indices. So if I have index A, index A, SDF, BB, and so on. Yeah. And this is the way how you create index. So you have a current titler and you have a list item. Yeah. And all of this works with, let's say, some magic which is happening inside the list widget and the variable names that are used. It sometimes can be confusing, but it is very, very powerful. Yeah. Just play a little bit with this, what I showed you here, and you will see how it works. Yeah, have fun.